talk to him.
Why? We have a great text relationship.
You know it's a better text relationship?
What?
Talk to him.
The brown-haired girl shows the blonde girl text messages and smiles. To Lucas, where you going? History, I sit next to you. Lucas reads Riley's text. So do I. Wink, wink.
He's right over there.
Lucas sits on a nearby bench.
Ew. Too complicated over there. Lots can go wrong over there. The only thing that can go wrong over here is if I go over there.
The blonde girl points toward Lucas. Riley hands her books to the girl and approaches the bench. As Lucas texts, Riley pops up behind the bench. Smiling, she rests her head on the back of the bench and mouths, "Hi. Hi. Hello," while Lucas stares at his cell phone. Riley turns to the blonde girl, who mouths words also, "Talk to him." Riley mouths back, "Okay." Then faces the back of Lucas's head and opens her mouth. Lucas types on his phone. Riley glances at the blonde girl, then stands and smells the back of Lucas's neck twice. She turns to the blonde girl, smiles, and throws up both hands. The blonde girl motions for Riley to return. Riley rushes over. The blonde girl hands Riley the books.
How'd I do?
You smelled him.
Yup.
You smelled him is what you did.
I walk through life the way I walk through life.
Can we please talk about this?
Walking off, Riley sends a text. The blonde girl reads a text message.
Nope.
Disney's Girl Meets World.
I've been waiting for a day like this to come, struck like lightning. My heart's beating like a drum on the edge of something wonderful. Face to face with changes. What's it all about? Life is crazy. But I know I can work it out, 'cause I got you to live there with me.
A dark-haired teacher.
You guys don't connect with each other. It's like you can't exist without these.
A cell phone.
You use emoticons rather than emotions. You're an unfeeling generation of zombies.
Riley pretends to gnaw on the blonde girl's face.
Stop eating her.
A black-haired girl walks in.
You're late, Miss Maisel.
My goldfish died.
You see, this is what I'm talking about. Miss Maisel has clearly suffered a tragic loss. Yet she does not seem in touch with her actual emotions.
Excuse me? I am crying my eyes out. I'm gonna have to leave class early.
The girl leaves.
Oh, she actually made it out the door this time.
He opens the door.
I actually made it out the door this time.
The girl returns. Riley smiles.
Dad, a just-in deal. Cell phones have been around for, like, ever.
It'll amaze you to know that there was a whole world before you and cell phones.
And it'll amaze you to know that I have 394 friends in here.
And I'm amazed that you believe that.
Riley's dad, Corey, draws a horizontal line on the chalkboard.
This is a timeline of all human existence. Starting here...
The beginning.
...is everyone who ever lived, laughed, loved, and understood the value of life. The cell phone era, which begins right around here...
Near the end.
...pretty much destroys all that. Way to go, you.
Sir... If I may take a different position.
Yes, yeah, save me, Mr. Fryer. Do I go too far?
Always, sir. I understand your point, but I use my phone to video chat my old friends and to find out what's going on in Texas.
Yeah. How else can you keep tabs on all the hoedowns and cattle pageants? Maya?
It's okay, Riley. I'm unaffected by Maya's views of country life. As my Uncle Buster always says, be like an eagle and soar above the mockingbird.
You're the mockingbird.
I know.
Maya turns to Lucas.
It kills me that I can't get to you.
Sorry, ma'am.
Farkle time, sir?
Oh, I love Farkle time.
Red-haired Farkle steps to the front of the classroom.
With all due respect to history, Mr. Matthews, what's important to our generation will be on this side of the timeline, when Farkle and technology rule. And I will easily be able to make another one of you.
Ow.
And another one of you.
Ow. Wait, so now there's four of us and one of you?
That's awesome. The future, you can't escape it. I am Farkle.
Farkle returns to his seat. Corey walks to the front of the class.
The assignment, you can't escape it. I am teacher. Okay, so here's what we're going to do, guys. We're going to split into teams and discover whether or not new technology has made us better people. You'll do presentations on your findings. And here's a twist. No computers.
What?
We're going old school. You're going to do your research at the New York Public Library.
Where?
And here's another twist, because I trust you not at all. Give me your cell phones.
No!
Yeah.
I don't want my
Come phone on, hand them up, hand them up.
The students give their phones to Corey.
Thank you. Okay, so our teams for this assignment, Maya.
Farkle sits on Maya's lap.
What up?
She pushes him off.
And Riley, you will be with... No!
He glances at Riley, then Lucas.
No! No!
Corey furrows his brow at Lucas.
Why did you have to come here?
Sorry I make you uneasy, sir.
Oh, Dad, we don't even have our phones. I mean, what could possibly happen?
Later, standing with Riley by the lockers, Maya stops Lucas as he passes.
Hey, Soaring Eagle, you walking with us to the library tonight?
Sure, if that's good with you guys.
Well, seeing as how you're Riley's partner on this assignment, I guess we should find out if it's okay with her. Riley?
Riley stares at Lucas.
Riley, any thoughts on this that might come out of your mouth in word form? No, because you don't have your phone anymore. So what are you going to do to communicate, I wonder?
Riley gives two thumbs up.
Oh, look at that. Two thumbs up from Riley. And a smiley face.
Lucas smiles at Riley and walks off. With her mom, dad, and younger brother.
It was a good day. And then my friends treated me nicely. And then my teacher measured us. And then I'm growing. And then Jenny Lewis loves me. I think because I'm growing.
It wasn't a good day. And then my friend pulled my hair out. And then my teacher took my phone away. Then my teacher was also my father.
At least you're growing.
Honey, please don't come apart.
Look at this as a beautiful opportunity to spend time with your family.
Riley smiles at her brother.
Hello, Riley.
How you doing?
Want to hear about my day? It was a good day.
Mom!
Forgive her, Augie. She misses her telephone.
Well, then she can have mine.
Augie hands Riley his plastic toy phone.
The cow goes.
Ooh.
She gives it back.
I'm not gonna make it.
That's what your father thinks.
She can't.
Honey, please don't make your father right. It's no good for any of us when your father is right.
She's right.
Why are you really doing this?
Because I want you and your friends to become human beings. And I believe that by doing this, you guys can learn to become real human beings.
Hey, losers, it's Maya.
accept her.
You know what? I am going to do this.
Riley leaves the table.
I can get through this whole thing without making a text or a call.
She presses the intercom button.
Come on up.
Of course you can, sweetheart. And you know what? You're already a wonderful human being, but every so often little tests like this are gonna come up.
Why?
Because it's your father's job to give you little tests. And maybe along the way, you guys are gonna learn a little bit more about yourselves.
Maya walks in.
Yeah, like I've learned that I'm actually really okay with all of this.
You don't miss your phone, Maya?
I was the only one in class without a smartphone anyway, and now I kind of feel like everybody's even. Sparkle. Be ready in a minute.
And Lucas.
Ready now.
Riley dashes out. Maya follows her.
Did you see that? You know what that was? That was boys. Too soon for boys. Not ready for boys. I don't want boys. We just gonna accept boys?
It happened. She's gone. She was nice. We had fun, but we still have him. You want a color?
Color!
Of course you do. Let's color for the rest of our lives.
Augie's mom gives him crayons while Corey clears the table.
Will I be getting a real cell phone someday?
Someday.
Dominic Falcone has a real cell phone.
Would you rather have a real cell phone or would you rather color with us?
Color with you. Does that get me a cell phone?
Not too much longer with this one either.
Well, you'll always have me.
Yeah.
Corey furrows his brow. Later, Riley ambles into the New York Public Library with Maya, Lucas, and Farkle.
What is this place? This is where the ancients stored all of their wisdom.
Look at all of those.
Books.
Look.
Lucas blows dust off a book.
Tales of Human Interaction.
We'll take it. Thanks, quick draw. Sparkle, do whatever you do with that.
You mean read? Chapter one.
Oh, I'm bored out of my mind. Let's go to a movie.
A bespectacled woman shushes them.
There's one of those ancients now.
They approach the librarian.
Oh, wondrous gatekeeper of the knowledge. We are travelers from another time and place.
Seventh grade middle school.
We wish to partake of this information from your great hall of wisdom.
Do you rent phones?
Shh.
There's no one here but us.
Why do we have to shush?
Let me handle this, Maya. She obviously likes it quiet.
Hello, book lady.
Well, hello. And who might you be?
I might be Farkle.
Would you do me a favor, Farkle?
Oh, you know I will.
Why don't you go over there and... Shh!
Well, that's disappointing.
Maya pulls Farkle over to a table. Riley stands with Lucas.
So...
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
This chapter is called Disconnect to Connect.
Not until we put down our phones, switch off our computers, and look in each other's eyes will we be able to touch each other's hearts. Yeah, like that's gonna work on anybody.
Riley and Lucas turn to each other and lock eyes.
People used to need places like this. Now we can hold everything that's here in a little device we can put in our pockets. I don't even need to look out this window to know what phase the moon is in or where the stars are.
Yeah, well, I don't have a phone like that. I just have the actual sky.
Oh, I'm so sorry for you. You're at a real disadvantage. That can be the basis of our presentation, okay? Wanna read back the notes?
What notes?
You weren't taking notes?
No.
Yeah, why bother? Without a computer, all we have is a pencil and a pad. What could we possibly do with that?
Farkle grabs Maya's pad and stares at her drawing of the moon over a city.
I had no idea.
Yeah. Neither did I.
Riley and Lucas sit at a table with open books.
My dad thinks that we have no idea how to talk to each other.
What if he's right?
Shh.
But we're not saying anything.
I know.
Then why are you shushing us?
Because I can't take it anymore. You guys are hopeless. Come here.
Riley steps over to the librarian.
Couple of sweet kids like you, and you sit there like a couple of lumps. You're a disgrace to every single story on these shelves.
Okay, so what do I say to him?
Look around. Nothing here but books about boys and girls and men and women and what they say to each other. Open any one of them and you... Nope, not that one. Oh, boy, not that one. Look, all of these books have one thing in common.
What's that?
They start on page one, and each page you turn brings you deeper into the story. What's your name?
Riley.
What's his name?
Lucas.
You like a good story, Riley? Then start at the beginning.
Riley walks over to Lucas.
Hi.
Hi.
She sits beside him. By the window, Maya reads to Farkle.
Because it's not until you've really looked at each other and made a human connection that you can even begin to know each other.
Look at my eyes.
No.
Look at my eyes.
No.
Look at my eyes.
No.
Lucas and Riley talk.
I guess the thing I miss most about Texas are the pets I used to have.
I had a hamster.
I had 24 horses.
You win. Tell me about them.
One day, after school, Sophia was falling.
That means she was giving birth, right?
Not too bad, city girl. And there was no one there. So I called Dr. Glonda, and he talked me through it. Anyway, that was all.
More.
Did you know that a baby horse stands in the first hour after it's born?
Really? I'd like to have been there for that.
The coolest thing I've ever seen. And I was a part of it. Riley?
Lucas?
I've never told this to anybody before.
Yeah?
I think someday I might like to be a veterinarian.
That's cool, too.
I delivered this beautiful palomino. I'd show you her picture, but I don't have my phone.
That's okay. Just keep talking.
Riley rests her head in her hand and smiles at Lucas. Nearby, Maya reads.
There is no connection you can make with any screen that compares to the moment you understand only human beings have souls.
I have a soul.
No.
I do.
No.
I do.
No.
At home, Augie sits on Corey's lap.
I colored a new picture.
Stay like this forever.
Would you please? That'd be great.
The picture's over there.
On a wall, three stick figures.
Mommy, Daddy, Augie, and no Riley.
Augie, I don't know if you
it's
should
It's beautiful.
Be-
I think that's what you're supposed to do. I have no idea.
And look at the refrigerator.
The new one?
That's a trip to the Jersey Shore.
It's beautiful. It's beautiful. I think that's what you're supposed to do.
Augie leaves the room. Riley returns home. She gazes off and smiles. Her mom cleans the refrigerator door. Corey squints at Riley.
How was your night, Riley?
Thank you for sending us to the library.
Really?
Yes. Lucas and I did really well on the assignment. I think that we connected.
What do you mean connected? What are you talking about? How did you connect?
We talked about stuff that was important to us. Too important to text. Did you know that when you listen to someone, they'll tell you stuff.
Oh, boy.
Friends talk to each other, but real friends listen. Maya knows how to draw. And I know how to be a real friend. You're a good teacher, Dad. You can keep my phone as long as you want.
Riley hugs her dad. As she skips to her room, her mom approaches Corey.
Congratulations, Corey.
What did I do?
You just taught our daughter how to feel.
I did that?
You did.
I didn't mean to do that.
Well, you did.
She has feelings now?
Mm-hmm.
How many?
All of them.
Well, put them back.
We can't do that.
I have a way.
There's no way.
I have a way.
In class.
Here you go. Take your phone. Take it now. Very good. Here's your phone. Good. Great. Nobody talks to nobody. No more feelings. Thank you. Okay, guys, the great technology debate. Let's boot it up.
Riley, Maya, Farkle, and Lucas stand at the front of the classroom.
I have always believed technology would help us fulfill our potential as a species. But when Farkle does rule the world, no matter what devices we come up with, we should also never forget what we can do with a pencil, a piece of paper, and our own imaginations.
Farkle shows Maya's drawing to the class.
I've been keeping this in my pocket where my phone used to be. I keep looking at it. I'm fine.
Thanks, Farkle.
Look at my eyes.
No.
I thought my whole life was in my phone. But it turns out that I don't really have any friends in here. And you don't need your phone to connect with your real friends.
Allow us to demonstrate.
Lucas and Riley face each other.
Hi.
Hi.
They face the class. Later, at the library, Corey pushes books aside on a high shelf.
I'm not that tall.
He bends down and peers through books on a low shelf.
Really?
Corey moves books aside on a middle shelf and talks to Maya.
How you doing?
You will keep an eye on Riley at all times. You will send me message alerts. You will send me pictures.
You're really scared, aren't you?
I'm a father.
Yeah. They're just friends.
Believe me, I know the story.
But you're forgetting I don't have the technology.
Now you do.
He places a box on the shelf. Maya walks around to Corey. She takes the box and pulls out a smartphone.
You got me a phone?
My motives are completely selfish.
I'm not sure they are, Mr. Matthews.
Well, I also got you these.
Colored pencils?
Yeah. You let me know everything that's going on with Riley. And if something beautiful ever happens, paint me a picture.
Maya smiles as Corey leaves. A list of credits follows. Description created by NCI Described Media. Michael Jacobs Productions. It's a Laugh Productions.